Today's video is dedicated to a good friend of mine, and her name is Nuria. She asked me to do a vegan burger, and I promised her a long time ago to do a vegan burger. So the ingredients I am using today are dried chilies, some white rocket, fresh basil, some tomato puree, fresh garlic, of course we need some salt, we need some lemon juice, we need some firm tofu, we need some canola oil, we need some olive oil, and we need some chipotle chili powder. If you can't get chipotle chili powder, use cayenne pepper. We need some liquid smoke, of course. We need some sweet white miso paste. Then we need some rice vinegar. We need some pine nuts, some aniseed. We need some cashew nuts. We need some mozzarella style dairy free cheese thingy. Then we need some dairy free hard Italian style cheese thingy. We need some soya mince. Then we need smoked paprika. We need some garlic powder. We need dried basil. Of course, we need some freshly ground black pepper. We need some strong white flour. We need some wholemeal flour and some sugar. Smash it.
Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now let's get started. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and the first thing to do is make our pesto.
Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, grab yourself here one of those measuring bowls, then get yourself your basil. We need 31 grams of basil. Simply add the leaves to your measuring jug, like so. And now grate in about 50 grams of your vegan hard Italian style cheese, like so. And it doesn't smell like Parmesan cheese, and it doesn't taste like Parmesan cheese. Nevertheless, it's for the vegans. Righty right, to this I'm adding about a quarter of a tablespoon of salt. Now I'm adding half a garlic clove, peel it like so, cut off the ends, and then get rid of the paper layer, then cut it in half like so, and add it. Your pesto. Right. And now I'm adding about half a tablespoon of pine nuts. Unroasted. And now I'm adding about 3.5 tablespoons or 50 mils of olive oil, like so. If you need more, add more. Right. And now get your blender and mix everything together, like so. Right, and when you have a nice paste, transfer your pesto to a bowl, like so. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now cover your bowl with cling film, like so, and set aside until needed. Smash in.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, after that much work, it's time for a recipe.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now let's make the tofu-based sour cream. If you eat dairy products, skip all the steps and use sour cream instead. Anyway, it's vegan, so we do our vegan sour cream. To your measuring mark, add 200 grams of firm tofu. Make sure you drain the tofu and you pat it dry. Right. We need about 200 grams of tofu. Should be that much. Add it to your bowl like so. Right, ladies and gentlemen. And now add 2 tablespoons of cashew nuts. 2.5. And now add 1 tablespoon of rice vinegar. And now add 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. And now add 1 tablespoon of canola oil. Then add 1 tablespoon of your sweet white miso. Right, ladies and gentlemen. And again, it's time for your blender. Mix everything together until it's very, very smooth, like so. Right, ladies and gentlemen, cover your tofu based sour cream with cling film, like so, and set aside until needed. Smash in.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, and after that much work, it's time for a recipe. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's time to make the bread. Yeah, the bread. I'm not baking any burger buns. It's kind of a, let's say, flatbread style thingy.
First of all, grab a big bowl. And then add, I would say, 180 grams of strong wholemeal flour, and then add about 190 grams of strong white bread flour, and then add about a tablespoon of sea salt. Right. To your flour mix at about, I would say, 300 ml of lukewarm water. Then grab a fork and bring everything together, like so. And when everything is combined together, get your clean hands in and knead the dough for at least 10 to 15 minutes, like so. And when you have a nice and elastic dough, cover with cling film and set aside for at least 20 minutes. Smash it.
Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. After that much kneading, it's time for a recipe.
Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. And here I have a pot with about, let's say, 300 ml of water, and to my water I'm adding 2 tablespoons of mesquite liquid smoke. Then I'm adding 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Then I'm adding 1 tablespoon of garlic powder. Then I'm adding 1 tablespoon of chipotle powder. And now I'm adding 1 tablespoon of smoked paprika. And now I'm adding about 1 tablespoon of freshly ground black pepper. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. And now I'm adding about 1 teaspoon of dried basil. Righty right, now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of sugar. And now I'm adding 1 dried chili. Crack it up. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. And now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of aniseed. And now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of sea salt. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. And now bring this stuff to the boil. Stir everything together.
And voila, your mix is coming up to the boil. It's time for the recipe.
Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. And when your sauce is boiling at 100 grams of your soya mince, then give this a good stir. Take it off the heat. Cover with a lid and set aside for a minimum of 10 minutes. Smash it.
And while we are waiting for our soya mince to get soaked and take on all the flavors, it's time for a recipe. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. And now it's time to make the bread. So, first of all, get your bread or your dough. Divide this one. Get some flour because it's a bit sticky. So give it a little meat. Then divide your dough into
12 equal pieces, like so. Then get your pieces, roll them out. Like so, it's kind of a flat bread. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now bring your frying pan up to a low medium heat. No oil whatsoever. And while your pan is heating up, it's time for the recipe. And repeat with the remaining dough. Smash it! Righty right, so place your flatbreads into the pan, like so. And dry fry until nice and golden brown on each side. Smash it! While your bread is getting nice and golden brown on the outside, it's time for recipe. Righty right, so turn over your flatbreads and fry for another 5 minutes. Smashing. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen. When your bread is nice and golden brown and sounds hollow, get it on a plate. Stack it up like this. And now grab yourself a plastic bag. Cover the bread because the bread is hot, it will steam and will keep the bread soft. Set aside until needed. Smash it. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, to my vegan burger mix I'm now adding 150 grams of strong wholemeal flour. Special. Then I'm adding 170 grams of tomato puree. Right, and now I'm adding 4-5 tablespoons of our tofu based sour cream. Let's go for 4. And now I'm adding another 4 tablespoons of olive oil, and now mix everything together. If it's too dry, add a bit more sour cream or tofu sour cream, but this should be enough. Stir until everything is well combined. Righty right, so when everything is well combined, divide this mix into, I would say, 6 patties, and then Let's get frying. Smash him.
Right. After that much work, it's time for recipe.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, and again, bring this frying pan up to a heat, medium, I would say, yeah, medium. Then add, I would say, 2 tablespoons of olive oil.
While your oil is heating up, it's time for the zippy.
Right. To shape your patties, get your hands wet. Then grab the amount of, I would say, kind of a softball. Then shape it into a patty. Like so. And into your frying pan. Right, ladies and gentlemen. Fry these on a medium heat until nice and golden brown on each side. Should take about 5 to 6 minutes. Smash it.
And while your patties are frying, it's time for a zippy.
Right. When your patty is nice and golden brown, turn it over and then get your vegan mozzarella style cheese. Cut off some slices, put them on your patty, right, ladies and gentlemen. And now we have put on the vegan cheese, or vegan mozzarella cheese. Put the lid on the pan and allow the cheese to melt. And this should take about 10 minutes.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's time to plate up.
So first get your bun, or the first flatbread, then get your pesto, give it a good mix. Get a tablespoon on this, maybe this, get half a tablespoon, then get your white rocket. Then get your other half. Then again another half a tablespoon of your pesto. Then Then get your patty. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and here we have it, my vegan or my Italian inspired vegan burger with wild rocket, vegan pesto, flatbreads, vegan cheese, Nuria. I hope you like this stuff. So this is the Italian inspired vegan burger. Anyway, as always, at this time, sorry, at this place, at this very moment, it's time for the tea. Bye bye and see you next time. Special.